if you want to be more famous, or you want to travel, or you want to do something more special, I always recommend that you have to keep taking workshops.
Whether you're a professional dancer or just started falling in love with ballet dance, welcome to the Ballet Dance Life podcast. Here, we are diving deep into all facets of ballet dance world that cannot be found in a workshop or an audience seat. Every week, you will find new, honest, thought-provoking, inspiring, and educational conversation with top leading professionals of our industry. I'm your host, Iana Komarnytska, and I'm honored that you are part of our dance tribe. Jelena's BDE is excited to offer many training and performance opportunities to intermediate and professional level dancers. Visit joinbde.com for information on how to join their professional cast or to train and perform with BDE Experience program. Gain a unique and professional level experience with training in technique, choreography, performance, and theatrical productions alongside Jelena and her team of directors. Information is available at joinbde.com. Hello, hello, guys. How are you doing? How's your dancing going? We are approaching our final week of Ballet Dance Life Podcast Challenge. Yes, I can't believe we started almost 2 weeks ago, and this is our... Actually, we started 2 weeks ago, and this is our third week of Ballet Dance Life Podcast Challenge. Four videos are already released, and it's so cool to see your videos on Instagram learning this choreography. And tomorrow, literally tomorrow, December 11th, there will be fifth part released, and we will have complete routine. Can you imagine how cool it would be now to travel from festival to festival, meet people who know exactly the same choreography, and dance together to the soundtrack of our Ballet Dance Life podcast created by Pedro Bonato? I can't wait to see that. I'm even thinking, should we start flash mobs? That would be super fun. If you don't know what I'm talking about, or you missed some of the videos and don't know if you can still join us, of course you can. Officially, we are running till December 15th, and there will be a bunch of cool presents and gifts prepared for you and for upcoming holiday season. But, of course, you're welcome to join and dance with us whenever you hear this information, whenever you discover about the challenge. Just go ahead to the webpage, yanadance.com/challenge. I'll put it in the show notes too, and find out all information about all previous parts of the choreography, about music, about our awesome teachers, and everything you need to know in order to learn this drum solo routine. So don't hesitate and just join us. And as much as I'm excited about our current challenge, I'm also excited about our today's guest, because yes, you probably already saw on the poster and title, we are having an amazing episode with David here. And I had the pleasure to meet him during his visit to Ukraine, and he was teaching and performing here at the dance festival, and his personality, charisma, and technique is literally something extraordinary. All dancers at the workshops were just shocked with all the power of dance passion that he poured on us. It was absolutely amazing, and I really sincerely recommend whenever you have opportunity to visit his class, don't hesitate, just go, because you will be just infused in the ocean of new ideas and new dance tricks and challenges, and the way he puts his choreographies and sequences and techniques is absolutely amazing. So really recommend, highly recommend, go and study with him. David is originally from Argentina. Now, today, he travels all around the world. He also graduated from Amir Thaleb School, and he has very unique and touching story about that and how he began his journey in ballet dance, which of course we will be talking about during the interview. But also, For those who are interested in developing your international dance careers, he gave invaluable tips and suggestions based on his own experience. So tune in, stay with us till the very end, and I know you already can't wait to dive into this episode. So without any further delay, please welcome amazing David.
Hello, David. Welcome to Ukraine, first of all, and then welcome also on the podcast. Very happy to talk to you today.
Yes, well, thank you so much. I am so excited to be here in Ukraine also.
Well, looking forward to upcoming workshops too. How do you enjoy your stay so far? Like, you've been here for a few days only, but...
Yes. Well, it's very nice. I love the city, and also I spend some time giving class and spending this time for the weekend to give workshops and competition and show. Uh-huh. So it's nice.
Well, before we dive into like your, in general, like dance activities and traveling and workshops and everything that you do, how did everything start? Do you remember your very first ballet dance class?
Oh, yes. I remember like every time. This was like because my mom, she fell in love with some novel, some series in Latin America, El Clon, you know, maybe. There's Jade and Oriental Dance. And she fell in love with this and she started to study by herself with the tutorials and DVDs and VHSC. So she then learned and teach to us. So yes, my mom was my first teacher in belly dance.
And do you have sisters and brothers in your family?
Yes, I have 7 brothers and sisters.
Oh, wow.
Yes. And also she teach to my sisters. And we just have a fun, I mean, just like a hobby. Where the music starts in the TV and we start to dance, like having fun. And also my sisters are dancers too.
Oh, really? That's so awesome. Yes, that's great. Right. I didn't know. It's like the family, not business, but family, I don't know, profession, art, hobby. Yes.
They are doing like a hobby when I arrive to the city and they want to dance and they also take my class when they arrive.
That's so awesome to have like family activity.
Yes, it's very nice.
But how did everything like eventually continue? Because everything started as a hobby. Is your mom teaching you? And when did you went to school afterwards? Did you study on your own?
When I was 8, I started like a hobby, take some ballet class, Spanish dance, flamenco, and all this fusion. And when I was 18, I decided to travel to Buenos Aires from my city to Buenos Aires to the Amir Thaleb School, Arabian Dance School, to start to study there because Amir Thaleb invited me to the school to study and also he gave me like a free annual lesson. I don't pay anything in the school, so was here invitation to study in this. This program, I mean, to take all the class by free, and I know it was a super special opportunity.
Yeah, that's very special. I'm very curious here about your opinion because we had quite a few guests previously on podcast from Argentina, and everyone is talking about Amir Thaleb School.
Yes.
What do you think is so special there that what he or teachers they give to students that we have so many internationally known Argentinian dancers who all went, or most of them refer to Amir Thaleb School?
Well, I think it's one of the most important schools in Argentina for us because he was one of the first, like a belly dance male teachers. And also he gave a lot of opportunity to all the students. So also is very famous dancers and teachers from the school, like Saida, Leandro Ferreira, and is a lot of teachers. I mean, in the school you have a very, very good education, like about the styles, about the traditional dancers, and about traditional styles, I mean. So it's very special and it's very nice place to study. I really enjoy. I was there 2 years and I have also, every time I have a very good memories from there.
And you moved to Buenos Aires or you were going to Buenos Aires from time to time for this class?
I was 2 years. I was living in Trelew, it's in the southern, in the Patagonia. I traveled in around 25 hours by bus to the capital every month. And was 2 years like this. Wow. But I never moved to Buenos Aires. And then around 6 years ago, I moved to Mar del Plata. It's in the province of Buenos Aires, but still near more, not like 24 hours. It's just 6 hours.
Wow.
But it's still fine for me.
But it's incredible to travel 25 hours.
Yes.
Every month.
Every month for 2 years.
Wow.
What
did you move to spell? Because for so many people, it's like 40-minute travel within a city, it's just, oh no, it's too far, I'm not going to go to that class or workshop. What did you move to go 25 hours every month?
Yes, every month, like every month. I don't know. Well, I think it was the passion and this like feeling to learn because in this moment I don't have a lot of idea, a lot of technique. So it was just the only things that I had to do to improve my dance, to improve my style, to be someone in this career, I mean, because just was my only opportunity to travel because I don't have to pay also because it was so difficult. The economy in Argentina, you know, maybe sometimes it's difficult and hard. So just was my opportunity to study and have this chance to have like a Amir Thaleb, like a teacher, Jonathan Palermo, Shael, Leandro, Yusuf Constantino, there's so many and they're so good, like in the class. I always remember them, so, so nice person. It's very nice.
And which moment was then you realized that you want to have dance, not just as a hobby or actual profession?
I think when I finished the carver in the Amir Thaleb school, when I was 18, in this moment, I think, okay, I want to maybe give some workshops in some cities. And I remember the first organization that invited me to give some workshops was super near to my city. And I remember that I was feeling so excited about this, but I never imagined that, like, I will travel to some other country. My first desire was traveling in the Argentina, give some class in the cities. And then I think at 18, I just start to feel like, okay, I want to travel. I want to meet new person, give class and give something to some students that want to learn from me.
And there are so many dancers all around the world who dream about exactly what you dreamt about, like giving workshops. So how was your first workshop? Was it they just invited you, you reached out, or maybe you have, I don't know, some tips now with your experience of how to help people like to step that like to first time?
Yes.
First workshop.
Yes, I just recommend that you have to believe in yourself and you have to give